That black?
Thanks, Al.
Where's Mac?
He's in court.
Where's Hamilton and Singh?
Well, that numbers paper they've been working on, they got the store staked out, and when the bagman comes to pick up the week's tape, they're gonna grab him.
How come they left you out?
Because they said they could handle it themselves.
And you didn't argue?
Well, not with all this paperwork hanging over my head.
Out the money.
How come? And why can't we go right now, sis?
Because I say so, that's why.
Well, go away.
Chase 4 to 3.
Let's move on him.
Hold it, Chase 4. Wait till he comes out with the money and the betting slips.
Roger. We've got a piece of cake. I'm moving in on him.
Come on, give me the bag.
Look, what are you trying to do? Hey, you crazy? You guys crazy?
Hold it! Police!
Pete, come on.
Freeze, police!
Freeze? What do you mean, freeze?
Singh, where are you?
Wait a minute, will you? I'm stuck up here.
Singh, will you get over here? Against the wall.
Those two guys.
Never mind those two guys. Where is it?
I just got heisted.
Wait a minute. You mean those two guys?
I'm trying to tell you.
They got the bag?
They got everything. Where were you when I needed you? A whole week's work.
$6,000 cash and some slips with numbers on them.
That's good, huh, Rita?
Oh, crime and Ebert, $6,000, you could get 5 years.
Well, it's living, ain't it?
Some living. You two ever think of trying for something really big? You know, I mean something really big.
Well, like what?
I don't know, but I'm gonna think of something.
You should have seen him get ripped off, not me.
That crazy rig slipped. It was all I can do. I'm hanging on to keep from busting my head.
From your quiet conversation, you sound like you blew the caper.
What the heck are you doing?
Trying to teach Fuzz here how to capture and hold a suspect.
How's he doing?
Great.
Great.
Well, that's very good. Now what happens?
Well, at this point, you see, I come along, and the dog releases the suspect to my custody.
And that's a neat trick.
Watch this. Okay, Fuzz. Off, boy. A Fuzz, come on. Move back. A Fuzz. Look at me. Fuzz. Get up, you dumb dog. Move back.
I think he needs some more training.
Wait a minute. Well, we trained him a little bit, that's all. Give me a minute to concentrate here. Okay, Fuzz. Off, boy. Look at you, dumb dog.
What's going on here?
Fuzz won't let him up.
Fuzz, off.
Thanks.
Don't mention.
Not a word. Not one word.
Yes?
Captain Reddick is here.
Good, send him in.
Sorry I'm late, Chief, but you know how it is. What's up?
In two words, Suetonius Parker.
Is he back in town?
And operating.
Oh, that's too bad. What's that got to do with me? He's bait for the Bunko Squad.
Not anymore, he isn't. He's bait, as you put it, for you.
Oh, come on, Chief. He's a lousy con artist, even if he is the best in the business.
I wasn't asking, Chase.
No choice, huh?
Not at all.
Why?
I'm taking heat from upstairs. It seems the commissioner's brother-in-law got taken, and taken good by Parker. And now?
I'm getting taken by you. You know, there's no justice.
If there was, we might both be looking for work.
$12 million pie waiting to be divided.
Which one?
That one. Second from the left. A type of warship much in demand by some of your smaller countries. They'll pay in Swiss gold francs in Zurich. No fuss, no trouble. And best of all, no income tax.
Government won't sell?
Not for resale, you're correct.
Then what are we talking about?
Salvage, my man. We'll put in a bid for salvage. A paltry sum, like $500,000 or so.
Well, what makes you think they'll accept our bid?
Such bids are handled by the General Accounting Office. Now, I happen to know a top administrator is suffering financially. The usual thing, your market losses, an extravagant wife. All in all, a type of man who might listen to reason for a price.
$50,000. You have a deal.
$50,000?
Well, I am risking 10 years in federal prison.
I know. But you must realize, however, that this is most unethical, Mr. Mears. You did quote $10,000.
Price is 50. Take it or leave it.
Well, Mr. Willis?
Pleasant and L. Tyson, the third.
Looks like money.
$50 million worth. An appetite for well-stacked bonds and an idea he's a shrewd investor.
You know, if you took off his mustache and put him in blue jeans, he'd look just like Mac.
You know, if you got Mac to grow a mustache and dressed him up a little bit, he'd look just like Tyson.
Yeah. What if this guy Tyson should show up?
Not a chance. He's in Switzerland drying out from his last escapade on the Riviera. Nice try, Mac, but the caper is on.
And the bleeding of the kid excites the tiger.
I'll pretend you didn't say that.
Reserve a suite, Corrine. Then have your hairdresser dye your hair. Remember, Mr. Tyson prefers blondes.
Excuse me. Do you have a light? Is that all right? What do you do, Mr. McCrae? I mean, for a living.
I do, a lot of different things.
Now, that's a very oblique answer. You know something? I don't think your name is really Sam McCrae.
Why not?
It's too ordinary. There's more to you than meets the eye, darling.
Well, actually, I'm an international jewel thief on the lam from Interpol.
Very funny, Mr. McCrae. Oh, here comes my uncle.
Corrine, I've been looking for you.
I'm sorry, dear. I'd like you to meet a new friend, Sam McCrae, my uncle Suetonius Parker.
Suetonius?
My parents were classical scholars. They gifted me with the name of an Antonine prefect. Did you say the name was McCrae?
Sam McCrae.
I see. Well, any friend of Corrine's must be taken at face value. Come, my dear, we have that business with the Treasury people.
I'm sorry, dear, I forgot.
Will I see you again?
Call me.
I will.
And your incognito is perfectly safe with us, Mr. McRae.
Mr. McRae, sweet.
Sam, darling.
It's for you. Hello.
Good morning, darling.
Who is this?
Who's this? How many women have you met since you've been in town?
Corinne?
Of course. Uncle Suetonius and I were wondering if you would care to join us in our suite for breakfast.
I'll be there in 10 minutes.
We'll expect you then. He's really so boyish, so eager.
Corinne.
Well, he's really very nice.
Let's keep this on a professional level, Corinne.
My darling. Oh, of course I will. Mm. Have I failed you yet? Good morning, darling. Nice to see you again. Jesus, business. Would you care for some coffee or tea while we're waiting?
Coffee.
Now, just a minute. No, definitely not. I'm not a man who submits to extortion, sir.
Cream or sugar?
Cream.
But we had a firm agreement. I understand the risk, but you committed... Is that your final word? Very well, I'll call you back. I'm so sorry.
Is something wrong?
The business deal is going sour. The price has doubled.
But he can't do that.
I should have anticipated it. When one deals with that kind of cheap trickster. Call Lavoisier in Paris, my dear. I must have a full accounting of my reserves.
But do you think it's wise to go into your reserves, Uncle?
I'm in too deeply already. I must salvage my investment.
If you'll excuse me.
Oh, of course. Perhaps we should make this some other time.
No, not at all, sir. I'll not permit the chicanery of a low trickster to spoil this happy occasion. Oh, come in. Sit down, sir. Sit down. I've taken the liberty of ordering an English breakfast. I understand you're partial to that sort of thing.
Whatever gave you that idea?
Oh, come, my boy. There's no need for secrets between us. And I've already assured you, your incognito is safe with me. Ah, kidneys and bloaters. How delightful. Serve Mr. McRae first, please. Dig in, Mr. McRae. Dig in.
Delightful.
Henri is on the phone.
Ah, excuse me, please. Good morning, Henri. Oh, I beg your pardon. I keep forgetting the time difference. Good afternoon, cher ami.
Something is wrong, isn't it?
Uncle Suetonius has so much tied up in this business.
Oh, I see.
But, Henri, I can't help it if the scoundrel won't stay bought. He demands another $250,000. Henri, I cannot lose this deal. There are millions involved. I must raise the money somehow.
Well, what about my Bank of Zurich shares?
I see. Kimberly Myers? Yes, yes, I know it means taking a loss, but see what you can do and call me back. Now, time is of the essence. Au revoir, cher ami. Well, we shall know in a couple of hours.
Know what, Uncle?
Whether we shall be paupers or rich beyond our wildest dreams.
That much at stake?
About 40 millions. 40 millions in the most marketable commodity in the world. Gold.
Thank you.
good man, is a king's fortune.
Well, I'm listening.
You sound skeptical, my friend. And well, you should be. But it's true. Nearly $40 million lies there for the taking.
$40
million? As close as I can figure it. Amidst the government land is a gold mine. A gold mine as rich as the first Comstock lode.
Well, how'd you find it?
That has to remain my secret, my friend. But you can believe me, it does exist. Here.
Looks like gold, all right.
It is. Pure as fine in 30 years. Here's the assay report.
All right, I believe you. But how are you going to get the government to let you on the land to mine it?
We can't. That would involve disclosure, in which case the government would take everything. No, there's only one way. Purchase the land.
Well, that would be nearly impossible, wouldn't it?
Well, there are ways, Mr. McRae. Government servants are notoriously ill-paid, you know.
Bribery?
Does the thought shock you, sir?
No, not at all. But what's the hang-up?
Well, a dishonest civil servant to whom I paid money in good faith and who now refuses to go through with the deal.
Well, how much you pay him?
$250,000.
And now?
He demands another $250,000 to push through the condemnation of the land for sale.
Then you would buy the land?
For mere peanuts, my friend. A few acres of land for no more than $200 an acre. Frankly, I'm at my wit's end.
Can't you raise the extra money?
No, I'm afraid I can't.
Well, in that case, maybe I can be of some help.
You mean,
I mean, first off, I'd like to meet the civil servant.
Well, let's consider it done.
Well, there's the deal. Or you have no deal.
But I really don't understand, my good man.
First off, I'm not your good man. Secondly, I don't like what I'm doing. Thirdly, I have to do it for reasons I don't choose to tell you. But if I'm going to risk 10 years in federal prison, I certainly am going to be well paid for it.
$250,000 is being well paid, I would think.
Excuse me, I think your friend believes $500,000 is really being well paid.
Correct.
But I can't raise it.
Well, maybe I can help you.
You? How?
I guess I'll just have to put up the rest of the money.
Well, I really don't know how to thank you.
Well, I think 50% of the profits would be thanks enough.
Oh, well, my dear boy, you must remember the time I put in, the work.
But it all means nothing without my money.
Well, there's enough for all. You've got a deal.
You'll get your money.
Fine. The sooner the better.
Of course.
Gentlemen, when you need me, you know where to find me.
To a successful partnership.
All right, we'll have stakeouts all around the hotel. Now, don't get careless with this money.
You act like it was your money.
Yeah, well, the department gets a little picky about losing $250,000. Get going. We'll be right behind you.
Chase Commander.
They just turned into the garage.
Roger, three.
just relax.
Come on.
What's up, boss?
Well, he probably hasn't reached the room yet, Chase 3. Stay loose.
Roger, Chase Commander.
Why don't you sit down and relax?
He's late.
Just 5 minutes late. He'll be along.
Would someone please tell us what's going on?
You've been kidnapped, mister.
You've got to be kidding.
Easy, Steve. Who do you think we are?
We know who you are, Mr. Tyson.
Oh, they're crazy, Mac. Look, sweetheart, you're in real trouble. You...
Baker, how much is the bite?
$250,000.
Or else? It's going to take us a little time to raise that kind of money.
Well, that's one thing we got plenty of is time.
That's right. You think about it.
Look, Mac, fun is fun, but we let these creeps know who we are.
Yeah, we let them know who we are, and they'll blow our heads off. No matter who they think we are, this is still kidnapping. Just give me a chance to think here.
Disappeared? What do you mean they disappeared?
They never came out of the parking garage.
What about the money? Chase, that's $250,000.
I know it is, but I'll find him. Just don't blow the whistle.
You have until 6 to come up with some answers, Chase.
And then what?
We'll put out an all points on Baker and McCray.
Howdy, fellas. You sign this, Mr. Tyson.
Ransom. You're wasting your time.
Okay, then we bounce around a little bit.
Yeah, and I bet he bounces real good, Al.
You boys, shut up. Mr. Tyson here's too pretty to get all busted up.
Rita's got a fella. Rita's got a fella.
Don't you pay them no mind. You just sign this. You better do like I say right now.
Look, it's no use. My people won't pay any attention to a ransom.
Oh,
I'm not stalling. A man in my position, I run this risk all the time. So my people have instructions to turn all such demands over to the FBI.
If they do, you're dead, mister.
That's right. Ain't nothing else we could do.
Well, in that case, there's only one thing to do. And that's send him out with a note.
What are you... You think we dumb or something?
Well, if you want to get anywhere at all, you listen to me. Because my people won't pay any attention to a ransom note, but they might believe him.
I'm gonna go figure this out, but I'm gonna be right back.
Okay. What's the idea?
Well, I'm gonna try to get one of us out of here where we can do some good.
Now, Mr. Tyson. Get on back here. I don't want you dilly-dallying around town. You understand that? I mean it. You're cooking dinner for a millionaire.
I guess a millionaire's going to eat beans.
Not out of can, Al.
Rita Mae, what makes you so particular about what this fella eats?
I just don't want him to get a wrong impression of us.
You ain't taking a shine to him, are you?
Well, maybe I am, and maybe I ain't.
What's the matter with her?
Listen about that fella. Beans aren't good enough for him. Well, if they're good enough for us, they're good enough for him.
Al, I've been thinking, what are we going to do with that guy anyway?
What are you talking about?
Well, I mean, it just don't make good sense. Us getting the money and then just letting him go.
What would you like to do with him?
Shoot him?
Yeah. After we get the money.
That's pretty good.
At least they didn't get the money. I'll let Sergeant Collins get it out of the trunk of the car.
What makes you think you were in the country?
It's just a feeling. It was quiet, like there weren't many people around.
When you were driving out there, did you notice anything?
Well, the road was pretty rough, and then we turned onto a highway. I think it was a left turn.
Anything else?
Cows. There were a lot of cows.
How do you know?
I could hear them. I could smell them.
You know, there's some feedlots south of the city limits. Maybe Baker passed by one of them.
All right. Not very much to go on. Let's concentrate our efforts on the south of the city. Whoever snatched you is probably new to the neighborhood. Maybe somebody will give us a tip. Let's go.
You don't want any more? Want a drink? Listen, I was wondering, how long you reckon it's going to take your friends to raise that money?
Oh, 2-3 days to week.
Well, I thought they just had to go down the bank and draw it out.
It's not quite that easy.
But you're rich.
That's why it's not quite that easy.
Well, Pete and Al are getting mighty twitchy.
You know, Rita, you're a very bright girl.
How you mean that?
Just the way it sounds. You're the one who thought this whole thing up. The kidnapping, the ransom note. It took some heavy thinking.
Well, I don't know. I reckon it did at that.
You sure did. Now that you can have all this money, I mean, a pretty girl like you, well, you should...
Oh, come on.
What?
You don't really think I'm pretty, do you?
I sure do.
You do?
Yeah. Look, you can trust me. Why don't you take these handcuffs off? You can trust me.
Oh. I'd like to, though. I would. I really would like to. But, you know, to tell you the gospel truth, Mr. Tyson, I like your money better.
Well, since you love my money so much, what would you say if I doubled that ransom?
You're kidding.
I happen to know where I can lay my hands on a $500,000 tomorrow morning.
Well, you just give me a note to go pick up the money and I'll go and get it.
No, it doesn't work quite that way. Forget it.
No, now, wait a minute. Now, let's just talk about it.
Well, I'm involved in this investment deal, and I'm going to close the deal tomorrow morning. You know, you people are costing me a lot of money by keeping me here.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
How much?
$20-30 million.
$30 million?
That's right.
That's a lot of money.
And if I don't keep that appointment, it's all going down the drain.
Well, there's no way you're about to get out of here till we get our $250,000, so you can just forget about that.
I said I'd double it.
You just wouldn't be trying any tricks, would you?
How can I try any tricks? You'd be there. Your people would be there. Just think about it.
Well,
I think he's trying to pull something.
Well, I'm just telling you what he said.
$500,000.
My. Now, Al, remember what Mama used to say? Don't let your eyes get bigger than your stomach.
I don't see anything wrong with us doubling our money.
Well, all we're going to get out of is a puny old $500,000.
What's a puny about $500,000?
Well, when you stop to figure it, him getting 20 or 30 million, if we go along with it.
Pete, now remember what Mama used to say.
Well, I'm just saying, there ain't no darn justice. Him getting $20 or $30 million, we doing all the work for a lousy $500,000.
Don't be calling that money lousy.
Oh, you think you're so tough. Well, I've had you right about to hear.
Would the two of you please stop this? We got more important things to talk about. Sit down.
Well, all right. I mean, you know, if both of you agreed on it, I'd go along with it. I'm just saying, there just ain't no darn justice.
Deal's a bust. We must accept our losses and prospect new territories. Let's go. Did you call the bellhop?
Answer it.
Yes? Why, Mr. McRae, I'd almost given up on you. Why, certainly, my boy. My niece and I'd be delighted to see you anytime.
Where to?
The Elysian Hills Hotel.
Hey, Al, was any change left?
Oh, shut up. Elysian Hills Hotel.
You sure this is the place?
How could I forget that bedroom with that iron bed?
Well, let's start over again.
Wait a minute, Captain. Maybe McRae hasn't given up on busting Parker.
You mean to tell me you think he's enlisted the kidnappers in the cause of law and order? You may be right. We'll meet back at the hotel. I'll get on the radio to Sergeant Collins, have him put the money back in the trunk.
Thank you.
my car.
Okay. Now you just relax.
Slipped in the shower, as if I haven't enough troubles already.
Well, your troubles are over.
My dear boy.
Now, if I may see the matching funds.
Oh, yes, certainly, of course, Corinne.
Here, Yvonne.
$250,000, if you care to count it, sir.
Please, sir. I'm sure it's all there.
Put the money away, Corinne. Oh, I'm afraid there's one more request I must make of you, my friend. As you can see, I'm hardly able to travel. Yet it's imperative that the funds reach that certain party immediately.
Then you want me to deliver it?
If you would be so kind. I'll close the case, Corinne. Close the case and give it to our friend.
Here you are.
Oh, the pain.
Oh,
it's agony. Oh, that's all right, dear. That's all right.
Perhaps it'd be better if you left.
Will he be all right?
Oh, quite all right, dear boy. Quite all right. Oh, our man will be waiting for you at this address. Are you sure you can find it?
No problem. Will you be all right?
Yes, it's all right. Thank you.
I tell you, if you soak that thing in cold water, take this well in.
Yes, thank you.
Oh, Corinne. See you later.
I'll be waiting, darling.
Chopper. Chase, when did Chase Commander, do you see him?
This is Chase Commander. He just turned right on Mountain View, heading west. Sergeant McRae. Police Sergeant McRae.
Such duplicity. And I suppose the money was marked.
I'm afraid you're right.
Singh, take him to the car.
Come, my dear.
All right, let's go. You know, I think I'm gonna miss all this.
Yeah, it's a way to live, all right.
Real class. I wonder how much a place like this costs.
$100 a day?
Oh, forget it. What about your friends, the kidnappers?
You know, I bet they're going to be pretty steamed up when they find out they've been double-crossed.
That is, if they check to see they got the money.
You know, it really doesn't matter. I have a feeling the boss is going to ask us to find them. Pronto.
Ask?
Yeah, that is too polite a word for the boss, but you know what I mean.
Hi, Mr. Johnson.
Thought she was going to get away with something, didn't you, huh?
Thought she was going to buy us off with a lousy $500,000, didn't
she? What we're trying to tell you, Mr. Tyson, is we want a piece of the big action. Isn't that right, boys?
Yeah, that's right.
So we figured maybe you'd take our newfound money here and invest it in your project.
I'd like to properly introduce you to a friend of mine.
Officer Steve Baker. And that's Sergeant Sam McRae.
Crumb-a-nannies!
Read him, mate. Now, I told you we should shoot.
Oh, shove!
You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. You have the right to speak with an attorney. Would you have an attorney present?